Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu over the weekend slammed French President Emmanuel Macron for calling for a halt to arms supplies to Israel, which is fighting wars in Gaza and Lebanon.
Is Iran imposing an arms embargo on Hezbollah, on the Houthis, on Hamas, and on its other proxies? Of course not. The axis of terror stands together. But countries who supposedly oppose this terror axis call for an arms embargo on Israel. What a disgrace.
Israeli Prime Minister said his country has the obligation and the right to defend itself and to respond, and that Israel will win with or without the support of the French president.
Well, let me tell you this. Israel will win with or without their support, but their shame will continue long after the war is won.
He assured the world that Israel would fight until the battle was won, for our sake and for the sake of peace and the security in the world. Tunisia held a presidential election yesterday with no real opposition to incumbent Kais Saied, widely tipped to win as his most prominent critics, including a key contender, are behind bars. 3 years after a sweeping power grab by Saied, the election is seen as a closing chapter in Tunisia's experiment with democracy. The North African country had prided itself for more than a decade on being the birthplace of the Arab Spring uprisings against dictatorship. Polling stations opened at 8 a.m. and closed at 6 p.m. Preliminary results should come not later than Wednesday, but maybe known earlier, according to the Electoral Board. With little hope for change in the country mired in economic crisis, the mood among much of the electorate has been one of resignation. Jailed opposition figures include Rachid Ghannouchi, head of the Islamist-inspired opposition party ENADA, which dominated political life after the revolution.
We live in here today, but the flag still stands for freedom.
Former U.S. President Donald Trump made a defiant return to the venue of campaign rally, where an assassin's bullet narrowly missed killing him in July. Calling the gunman a vicious monster, Trump vowed he would never quit, never bend, never break, to cheers of fight, fight, fight from the crowd.
Exactly 12 weeks ago this evening on this very ground, a cold-blooded assassin aimed to silence me and to silence the greatest movement, MAGA, in the history of our country, MAGA.
Trump's much-hyped return to Butler, Pennsylvania, came exactly 1 month before the November 5th presidential election, the outcome of which President Joe Biden suggested on Friday might not be peaceful. Trump lashed out at his political opponents, calling them the enemy within, who had pushed to indict him and who knows, maybe even tried to kill him.
He did not stop our movement. He did not break out our spirit. He did not shake our unyielding resolve to save America from evils of poverty, hatred, and destruction. Yet we are here this evening in record numbers. This is a big crowd.
Security was noticeably tighter than Trump's July rally, with sniper squads atop surrounding buildings and a surveillance drone deployed overhead. Billionaire Elon Musk joined Trump on stage, stressing the tight margins that will likely decide the election in battleground states like Pennsylvania, and encouraging voter registration.
We had one president who couldn't climb a flight of stairs, and another who was fist pumping after getting shot. Fight, fight, fight!